again and thanks for joining us after the break. As promised, we are keeping you updated on what all went on at the Mega Glam Dubai International Film Festival 2009. It's always reassuring when the glitziest world events are followed by a gracious cause. I'm referring to AMFAR, the Foundation for AIDS Research, which is an international non-profit organization dedicated to support of AIDS research. AMFAR regularly holds fundraiser events such as Cinema Against AIDS galas in Cannes, Toronto and Dubai. Third edition of AMFAR Cinema Against AIDS Dubai, which was held under the patronage of Princess Haya, was presented by DIFF and sponsored by Dubai Pearl.
Well, AMFAR is one of the oldest AIDS organizations in the world, and we are dedicated to ending the AIDS epidemic through research. We're a scientific research organization, but we also do work on public policy, on treatment education, on training of healthcare professionals. We have programs for children who are HIV positive, and our work is really about trying to end the epidemic, and we do that through innovative research.
And what are you expecting this year?
Well, you know, it's our third year in Dubai, and so I'm excited to be back. And the reality is this is a difficult time in the world. There are economic challenges everywhere. And yet, we have the most amazing partners in the Dubai International Film Festival and Dubai Pearl, giving us an opportunity to be here again and raise money for our cause.
Hollywood biggies like Mandy Moore, Matt and Christina Ricci, along with adding some star power to the event, also helped to raise $1.9 million for AMFAR's AIDS program to increase awareness of this epidemic in the Middle East. That's really marvelous.
How are you associated with AMFAR?
Well, I'm just hosting. I'm one of the hosts for the event, and I've been involved in the past with AMFAR. I think they're a great organization. They do so much great research work, AIDS research work, because, you know, it basically is simple. You know, we're only going to find a cure through research, so that has to continue.
Christina, how are you associated with AMFAR and how are you going to participate in tonight's event?
Well, tonight I'm co-hosting the event we're here basically just to host this amazing event and to help bring awareness to AMFAR and AIDS research and to help raise some money with the auction.
Are you auctioning something?
Yes, I will be helping with two items. A gorgeous Patrick Dumachier print of Brooke Shields and a one-of-a-kind Chanel bag that Karl Lagerfeld designed specifically for this auction.
Christina Ricci opened the event saying that our only hope to end this epidemic is research. Popular singer turned actress Mandy Moore treated the audiences to a moving musical performance, after which the highly anticipated live auction kicked off. The famous saying, with great power comes great responsibility. So kudos to all these fabulous souls who have taken action to do good to society in the best way that they can. High Life Dubai salutes you. Moving on now, we are headed to the red carpet for the screening of James Cameron's long-awaited thrilling adventure, Avatar. Your glam team at High Life Dubai spotted a few celebrities on the red carpet. Bollywood's chocolate boy Sameer Dattani, petite beauty Manisha Lamba, the complete entertainer Javed Jafri and Scottish heartthrob Gerald Butler.
Well, I actually originally came for the City of Life, which was the film which I participated in. And that was a prime purpose. And I had some other business to take care of in Dubai, so we just tied it up together. I've got forthcoming three films, which one is called Loot, which is Govinda, Sunil Shetty, myself, Mimo Chakrabarty. It's a crime comedy thriller. Then there's a film called Hello Darling, which is it's a comedy, social comedy, but based in an office where I play the Kamina Zaleel, Kutta Kamina boss. and lecturist boss. And I've got these three wonderful ladies, Isha Kopikar, Selina Jetli, and Gulpanar. And I have a wife, Divya Datta. And the story is between me, this lecturer's boss, exploiting these women in the office and how they decide to get back at me. And interesting story.
There's Well Done Abba, which is a Shyam Benegal film releasing sometime early next year, which we screened here at GIFF. And now we're here for the Avatar premiere. A lot to look forward to.
A film of mine. It's called Well Done Abba. It's made by a maestro maker from India called Mr. Shyam Benegal, who is acclaimed the world over. And I consider myself extremely lucky to be a part of this film.
And you're also going to be watching Avatar today. Are you looking forward to that?
Completely. I mean, I cried buckets when James Cameron's Titanic released. I fell in love with Leo, fell in love with Kate Winslet. And he's come back after a decade, more than a decade, you know. So this is a film that the world is really looking forward to.
That was a fabulous lineup of the stars who were all in your city. And of course, it's our job to bring them right into your living rooms. And if you're hungry for more, then keep watching High Life Dubai, because next week we have not one, but two heartthrobs lined up for you. We have Gerard Butler in conversation, followed by one-on-one chat with our very own Ranbir Kapoor. So mark your calendars and meet me again next week, same time, different place, to live the high life. But for now, it's me, Uma, saying bye-bye. Our gracious host for tonight's show is the luxurious Grand Hyatt Hotel, and I'm seated at the aesthetically designed Royal Suite. The City Conference Resort Hotel plays host to business travelers, conference organizers, leisure travelers, and also Bollywood stars like Salman Khan and the first family of Indian cinema, the Bachchans.
Hey everybody, this is Ranbir Kapoor, and please keep watching the most glitzy show on earth, High Life Dubai.